Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we have discussed about the various sorting techniques: bubble sort, merge sort, insertion sort, radix sort. Now we will discuss what do you mean by quick sort. In case of quick sort, we pick an element named as pivot. Now this element can be any element in the given array. We take this element as pivot and arrange all the other elements based on this element. What we do is pick up an element, put it as pivot, and left array, that is left hand side of this element, are values lesser than this pivot, and obviously then the values greater than the pivot are arranged to the right of the given pivot element, and like this your entire array is sorted. So in case of quick sort, we pick an element as pivot, left hand side values are lesser than the pivot value, these are sorted. After that, the right hand side value which are greater than the pivot are sorted, and like this your entire array is sorted. This case is called as quick sort. Let us look at the program how to sort the elements using quick sort algorithm. I've defined a class named as quicksort. Inside that, I've defined a function named as sort with the parameter arr, that is your array. We will be calling the quicksort algorithm, that is your quicksort logic, recursively. We have a quicksort function. First value will be quicksort arr, that is your array, starting from index number 0 going up till the array length. Hence we have arr.length minus 1. Then our quicksort function will be called recursively. Let's look at the quicksort function. With the quicksort function, we have the values parameter as array, low and high. Let's look how to calculate the values. We have I equal to low value and j equal to high value. Then we have a temporary variable named as temp. Now we will take the pivot value. For our convenience, we are going to take the midpoint value of the given array. Hence, we write down int pivot equal to arr, that is your array, low, that is your I value, plus high value, that is your j value. So, we have pivot equal to arr array, lowest value, that is the first element value, index number, plus greatest value, that is your high value, last element value. We are going to take the index number value. Remember, we have the index number value in this case. So we have arr low plus high divided by 2. So we get the midpoint of the given array. That particular element will be taken as pivot. So we will be arranging the element based on this pivot value. You must remember, in these cases we arrange the element based on this pivot value. The left hand side array based on this value will be having value lesser than this pivot value, and obviously the value greater than this pivot value will be arranged at the right hand side of the pivot value. Now we will look how to arrange the given set of arrays. That is, we are going to look at how to arrange the number of elements in the given array. We have partition values. While I less than equal to j, in that case we are going to check. While arr of I, that is your left hand side values, less than pivot, in that case if we are so, then we are going to increment the value. Hence we write down while arr of I less than pivot, then plus plus I of value, that is I plus plus. If not, then we will check with the array j, that is a high point value. We write on while arr of j greater than pivot, in that case we are going to decrement the value of j. Hence we write down j minus minus. Once this is done, then we will go for the swapping of the values. We write down if I less than equal to j, then we will go for the swapping, that is going to swap the values. Swapping logic is similar which we have discussed previously also. Temp equal to arr of I, so arr of I value will be transferred to temp. Then arr I is equal to arr of j, that is arr of j value will be transferred to I. Then the part remaining is to transfer the value of temp. Hence we write down arr of j equal to temp. Like this the value is swapped. Now what we need to do is to increment the value of I and decrement the value of j. Hence we write down I plus plus j minus minus. This is how you are going to sort the values, that is basically you are going to swap the value. Now what remains is to swap it recursively. Now we will be calling the function quicksort recursively. First half is the value lower than the pivot, and second half is the value greater than the pivot. First we will call if low is less than j, that is we are going to recursively sort the lower half. We write down if low is less than j, then we will call the quicksort function based on arr low and j. If not, we will be having the second half, that is upper half. We are going to call it recursively sort upper half. That is if a of I, that is if I is less than high, in that case we are going to call the quicksort by writing quicksort arr, that is your array I comma high. So in case of quicksort, basically what we do, we pick up an element, called it as pivot, arrange the all other set of element based on this pivot. The elements to the left of pivot are values lesser than the pivot, and obviously then values greater than the pivot are arranged to the right hand side of the pivot value. Like this your entire array is sorted. Let us look at the output now. Firstly, the user is asked to enter the number of elements. In this case, we are going to take the number of elements as 5. Let us enter the elements. As you can see, our quicksort algorithm is working perfectly fine. All the elements are arranged perfectly in the ascending order. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ikeda channel.